So I am from Hyderabad in India, which is like the southern part of India. India has got a lot of crime, but we are very good at hiding it. So we don't get to see a lot of it happening. Because I think like there's risk at every big city in the world. I mean, the bigger it is, the more scarier it gets because of the number of people, and there's so many sort of factors that are driving people towards violence and towards such kind of things. I never thought I'd like witness something in UK. I mean, I thought shit happens, but I never thought I'd be like a person that I'd actually see something happen. I used to work at a cafe as a barista. And this was like I think 7 months back. So I come back home from work at around like 4:30 in the evening, and so I just come back home, and I'm just on my bed, and like 5 minutes later I hear people shouting outside, and it felt like he was running away from someone. So I look outside my window, which is right behind my bed. I look outside my window and I see that this guy is running, and there's like four other people following him. And he stops right outside my window, and two of them remove their knives. So the first time they slashed him on his arm because he's stopping himself, so he gets cut like that. And then I don't know, I think he bent down or something, and then he got slashed on his knee, and then he just collapsed. And yeah, there was like blood everywhere on the floor, and he's at this point he's not even shouting. I think he's just collapsed. And these people just run away. And there's people all over, so it's like a very quiet neighborhood, so everybody could hear him scream. So now people have come out and they've just surrounded him. They're not even helping him. Somebody calls the ambulance, some people call the police. I am just sitting behind my window, just witnessing all of this. And then the police, first the ambulance comes, and they try to like plaster him up and try to help him. He was alive, he was safe, and I think he went back safe as well. And then the police come and they sort of put those tapes all around, the do not cross tapes. So they put all of that around. And they've started like asking questions to everybody on the streets, and they eventually come up to my apartment and they started asking me if I have seen anything, if I've seen anybody. They just asked for descriptions, and then I told them that I saw four people, two of them having knives. But I didn't see who they were actually, because they were like covered with their hoodies or whatever. And I explained all of this to them, but they didn't question me further about it. They just took down the details and they left. But yeah, as soon as that happened, I never felt safe, at least in that area. And I'd feel pretty unsafe going to work and coming back from work late at night as well. So, I mean, fortunately or unfortunately, I get fired from the job, so I don't have to go again, which made me realize that I should probably move out of the house soon because it was very unsafe and very unpredictable as to what would happen. There are a lot of gangs around, that neighborhood. So yeah, and I moved out, and it sort of shook me for a while. For like a good couple of months, I was very scared, and I was even, I didn't go as far as contemplating whether I should leave UK, but it certainly felt very, very scary to be in UK. But I think now I'm fine. I've moved on from what has happened, and I think now that I know that it's much more violent, I think, yeah, I think there's some positives about it, thinking that now that I know that what the hot spots are, where there's more violence, I can be much more safer, and yeah, stay safe. Come to the UK, it's a nice place apart from all the crimes that are happening. If you don't die, you're good. If you die, then I can't help it.